Back in 2018, I posted a video showing the first reloading bench that a friend and I built together. It was a great project, and I got a lot of use out of it, but having moved recently, it was time to say goodbye. The biggest change for me by far was space. The new house is roughly twice the size of the old one, which meant for the first time ever, I could actually live the dream and devote an entire room to my hobby. One of my best friends is a handyman who knows far more about carpentry than I do, so he designed the actual framing based on my previous bench using pine studs anchored to the floor and walls. More floor space also meant we could allow for a deeper countertop, which further increased both storage and work area. Another change I really liked was the decision to raise the entire bench about a foot higher than the old one. It's easier than ever to work not only while sitting, but also standing, and the ability to actuate press handles without having to lean over is a definite improvement. For finish, once again we chose to top the bench with 3/4 inch melamine, which provides a nice, clean, bright surface that makes it simple to work with, as well as keep track of small parts and components. After deciding I really liked the two-tone look of the room, I then went ahead and painted the framing white to match. Moving on to press placement, the added space meant we were able to include stations for each press, which are then further grouped into sections, including pistol, rifle, shotgun, and swaging. One of our biggest goals for the new setup was to maximize storage potential and better organize things. Press parts are kept nearby the models they're used with, while the ever-growing collection of shotgun slugs, wads, and swaging components are all within easy reach. There's also a shelf dedicated to reloading manuals and guides, with another set aside for special tools and gauges. The metal cabinetry shown here is nothing fancy, but makes a great place to store primers and other things I prefer to keep secured when they're not in use. Quite often when I'm working, I'll need to look something up online, or maybe just feel like listening to some music or a video to pass the time. An old TV, mini PC from Amazon, and some spare computer speakers made a great setup for research, watching videos, and just charging my phone. Once we'd finished, we had a little space left over in the back of the room. Not wanting anything to go to waste, we decided to build a small case prep bench. The top shelves serve as storage for some of my designs, while the bench top allows for bullet sizing, cartridge disassembly, primer pocket swaging, and general case processing. Despite costing the least, I think this is probably my favorite renovation since moving here. It's just an all-around great workshop, and the novelty of not having to move between rooms or drag things out of storage isn't going to wear off anytime soon.